Here this morning. Some of you have been in our events before. For many of you, it's your first time. And we have what I would call an action-packed three-day program. So we start this morning first by telling you what BIPs is all about. And then we will have a session on what is CVE, or what is countering violent extremism, followed by another presentation on the threat landscape. And then again tomorrow we will have two more presentations before and after lunch on the role of media in countering violent extremism, for which we will have practicing journalists talking to us, and youth radicalization in South Asia. On the third day, or final day, we will not have any presentations, but what we will have is a scenario response exercise. We will give you a briefing on that sometime tomorrow. And then we are very happy that Mr. Muhammad Munir Islam, DIG and Chief of the Counterterrorism and Transnational Crime Unit, has kindly consented to be the chief guest for the closing ceremony. We will also have a book launch of a publication that we have just come out with. So it's going to be quite a very interesting 3 days for all of us. And we are looking forward to learning from you, because you are the practitioners in the field, people who are working very hard to keeping this country safe. So we are definitely looking forward to learning from all of you. I would also like to extend a very warm welcome to our speakers, Dr. Smriti Patnaik from India, and Mr. Chiranjan Thapa from Nepal, and Maisha Kabir from Bangladesh. She's also joined us here this morning. So we're very happy that you, particularly to our overseas speakers who have traveled from both New Delhi and Kathmandu to be with us for these 3 days, we're very happy to have you here with us. So without further ado, I will request my colleague Samira Wadud to tell us a bit more about what BIPs is all about. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone, and a warm welcome. I'll just go over the few finer points of what BIPs is about. We were established 10 years ago, so that is 2007, and we're celebrating our 10th anniversary this year. BIPs was founded as an independent think tank. We're a non-party, non-profit institution devoted to the study of peace and security issues, not only in South Asia, but also on a global perspective. The mission of BIPs is fourfold. We're hoping to provide a platform for not only scholars and academics, but also people from more diverse backgrounds to come together and talk about the issues of security and peace that Bangladesh is facing, but more so how it affects the greater portion of Asia and also the world. Our core areas of focus are obviously traditional security, non-traditional security, and transnational security. For 2017, our revised trust areas are obviously countering violent extremism, part of which focuses on countering youth radicalization, countering prison radicalization, which we have a study on, and creating a comprehensive database on terrorism and violent extremism, which focuses mostly on the issues regarding Bangladesh. We also have CVE outreach programs. We're focusing on electoral violence and security, risk assessment and forecasting, which is a big part of what we do here at BIPs. Cybersecurity is a main focus for 2017 as well, under which we are also focusing on cyber radicalization, which has proven to be a big problem in Bangladesh in the last year or so. We're also focusing on critical cyber infrastructure security and information security. Security implication of climate change is also a big portion of what we're focusing on. Maritime security in the Indian Ocean region and under a specialized center, Strategic Dialogue. This is a brief overview of the activities at our institute. Again, we do research analysis and convening, training and outreach. We have a number of publications, which I'll go into greater detail later in the slide. We also disseminate narratives through our website and social media. We have a number of multi-track dialogues, which I'll go into detail later in the slides. And we heavily focus on media engagement as well. we aim to not only disseminate information within Dhaka and people who live here, but also people who are visiting here and might be interested in such issues as well, such as yourself and the audience today. We have a number of training and capacity building programs that we've done over the years. Counterterrorism capacity building is one of them. We are also doing currently a multi-year program for conflict, violence, extremism, capacity building. Our international workshop on countering the financing of terrorism. We also have a humanitarian law workshop internationally, which we did with the Red Cross in Geneva. As such, we also work with media personnel to build not only on how to report on severe issues such as terrorism and radicalization, and that's why we have capacity building training programs for the military. We've also in the past have had police training program and have published an e-governance strategy paper. We have a number of specialized centers and units, the main of which is Bangladesh Center for Terrorism Research, which Mr. Shafiq Munir is also a research fellow of. It works to not only combat the threats and issues regarding terrorism and radicalization, but also dispute a lot of the current phenomena around it, because this has been established in 2008, so it's well into its ninth year. We also have a Bangladesh Center for China Studies, which focuses to understand and study Chinese foreign policy, and in the light of recent events, we are more so focused on making this more of a platform. As I mentioned before, one of our specialized centers is the Strategic Dialogue Forum, under which we have a number of 1.5 and 2 dialogues. Our President, General Munir Zaman, has been the chairman of GMAC since 2013. And basically, GMAC is an organization that comprises a number of people from different parts of the world to come together to represent the continents and also work on the security implications of climate change, which Bangladesh has to focus more and more. This is just an overview of WIPS taking part in international events. Events in India, events around Europe. This is a brief, not comprehensive, but you will find that on our website, a list of our partner organizations. We firmly believe that it's important to work with like-minded individuals, but also organizations, to forward our work here done in Dhaka. We have a number of publications and we also contribute to international publications. We have one on the countering of terrorist insurgency, published in Russia, and the role of social media in influencing social relations. We also publish our own reports and publications as well. We have a number of issue briefs, all of which is available on our website in PDF format. We are highly vocal in the media, not only national, but more so internationally, spanning from the BBC to India to China. At BIPS, we heavily focus on social media and sending information and narratives through social media. We are completely active on Facebook, Twitter, and our talks are available on YouTube. Our website is regularly updated and our pictures are available on Flickr. Facebook has the highest penetration rate in Bangladesh, and we firmly believe that it's very important to take social media into account when discussing countering violent extremism in Bangladesh. Thank you. Have a good day.
Thank you, Sumita. So that's just a brief overview about what Bangladesh Institute of Peace and Security Studies is all about. As she mentioned, countering violent extremism has been a very key area for us. Countering violent extremism has been a very key area for us right from our inception, and we will continue to work on this issue as we identify this as one of the most critical security challenges facing our country right now. Within CV, however, we are looking at multiple different things, as she highlighted in our presentation, and one of the aspects we are looking at is the issue of cyber radicalization. And as a matter of fact, in January next year, we will be organizing a dedicated conference on cyber radicalization to understand the phenomenon in more depth. So before we launch into the proceedings of the workshop, I would suggest that we take a short coffee break and then reconvene here at 11.